friends. In this issue you will see the most popular buses during the Soviet era, and we'll talk a little about three of them. The first bus, which we will tell about, is the LAZ Ukraine of the first generation, which is now remade and used as a thematic coffee shop. In the 1960s, several prototypes of LAZ Ukraine were built at the LAZ auto plant. In July 1961, an experimental bus Ukraine was built at LAZ. In addition to a completely new body, the bus received a number of new components, such as air suspension and telescopic double-acting shock absorbers, power steering and pneumatic-hydraulic brake actuator, electropneumatic drive gearbox and drum-type handbrake. The second bus is GZU-651. After the Great Patriotic War in the USSR, there was a catastrophic lack of buses, especially in small towns and in the countryside, where the bus movement was not developed before the war. The main requirement for the car in this situation was not high comfort and reliability, but simplicity of design and maintainability. The country needed a bus, which could be mass-produced in large quantities in the shortest possible time. This bus was GZA-651. Buses GZA-651 had a metal body frame. The only passenger door led to the salon was opened manually by the driver using a lever mechanism. The driver's cabin was not separated from the cabin, but the driver had his own door. And the final third bus is LAZ Ukraine 71 and 73. The style of LAZ Ukraine 1971 formed the basis of future serial buses LAZ-699N. The bus LAZ Ukraine 71 had two televisions, a tape recorder, a radio, a wardrobe, a snack bar, a refrigerator, a coffee maker, a gas stove and a toilet room. 180 horsepower engine. The next Ukraine appeared in 1973. It was an even more comfortable liner with a slightly raised floor relative to the driver's cabin, due to which the bus became almost a 1.5. Subscribe to the channel, comment on the video and click on the bell. See you soon, folks.